So I'd like to call to order the meeting for the 21st of February for the Batavia Park Board of Commissioners at 7 p.m. Please call the roll.
Riley.
Here.
Foyle.
Here.
Tillman.
Present and accounted for.
Gray.
Here.
Kelly.
Here. All right, so please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, any items to be added, removed, or changed on the agenda?
Nope.
All right. So we'll start this evening's business with consent agenda. So I'd entertain a motion to establish the consent agenda as follows. Approval of the minutes of the regular board meeting of January 17th, 2017. Approval of the paid expenditures. Expense report approval. Investment summary. Income statement. Purchases. Ordinance number 367. Surplus property. And the CIP purchase of a pickup truck, a utility golf cart, and a ZTR mowers.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Tillman, second by Gray. Any further discussion? Please call the roll.
Riley?
Aye.
Foyles?
Aye.
Tillman?
Aye.
Gray?
Aye.
Callahan?
Any motion carries. So I entertain a motion to approve the consent agenda as established.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Tillman, second by Gray. All those in favor, signal by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Guests, matters from the public? Seeing none. Number seven, matters from the commissioners. Any commissioners wishing to make any comments this evening?
I've got a
couple things. I attended along with staff legislative breakfast last week. Very, very interesting. Our local legislators were there and talking about what's going on in Springfield, and I guess the legislator's going to be back in tomorrow. There's a lot of stuff under consideration, and pretty much everything's in play right now with this grand compromise, so we just don't know how it's going to come out. And a lot of these things have some big impacts on the park district. And, you know, a couple of the things that were bounced around was possibilities of a property tax freeze, either 2 years or permanent. There was one talk about a sales tax on our programs. There was talk about raising the minimum wage, which obviously impacts our budgets, along with many other
interesting
proposals. So fortunately, IEPD seems to be on top of it down in Springfield and sending out the legislative alerts.
Mm-hmm.
We'll just have to keep an eye on those.
I've kept in close contact with Jason Anselman from IEPD, and he said a lot of this is just rollover from last year. It's a lot of the same discussion. There's not a lot of movement on it right now. And when Governor Rauner is going to be starting his campaign to run for governor again, so a lot of this is just politically charged with position statements, but not a lot of substance behind what's being said.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot of fear mongering.
Yeah, one of the things they're talking about with this grand compromise is there were, what was it, 12 or 14 bills, but the only way they go into effect is if all of them get passed, and it didn't seem like there was support from either side of the aisle for, you know, there were a few that made sense for everybody and a few that the Republicans liked, a few that Democrats liked, but it didn't seem like there was broad-based support to pass the whole package.
Yep.
So probably more of the same is the message we got.
Mm-hmm.
Well, thanks for going.
Yeah, staff appreciated seeing you there too.
Yeah. Anyone else? Okay. Moving on, item number eight, correspondence. So we have four pieces of correspondence. One is a thank you note to the Park District for support of the Batavia Interfaith Food Pantry and Clothes Closet. The other one is a letter from former Depot Museum Director Carla Hill for the opportunity to work at the Park District. Carla, if you're watching, the direct opposite is true.
Exactly.
Thank you for the note, yeah. But we love you. Number three, thank you note from New Horizons preschool teacher Kaylee Gallagher for 20th anniversary gift. Well, congratulations to her. And number four, congratulations note from Beard Warner broker associate Bob Riley for achieving the Chicago Tribune's top workplace status.
An interesting note to add to that. So this particular real estate broker is actually going to start promoting Batavia because of our Chicago Tribune Top Workplace bit. So they're using the logo and using the Park District as another reason to move to Batavia.
Outstanding.
Mm-hmm.
That's great. Awesome. Okay. Announcements.
New Horizons Preschool is now enrolling for the 2017-2018 school year. Registration can be conducted in person over at the Eastside Community Center or at the Civic Center during open business hours. For more information or to schedule a tour, you can contact Lori McDonald at 630-406-5282. And brides, don't let the stress of wedding planning get you down. Stop by the district's second annual bridal showcase on Saturday, February 25th from 9 a.m. to noon in historic Shannon Hall. You can chat with local vendors, enter to win a number of raffle prizes. A variety of vendors will also be on hand, including photographers, florists, DJs, bakers, and much more. The first 50 brides will also be receiving a complimentary tote bag. And also, the Batavia Dance Recital is coming up on Wednesday, March 8th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Batavia Fine Arts Center. A link to purchase tickets is available on the district website at this time, and we invite all of you to join us to celebrate all of Batavia's young dancers. Thank you.
Thank you. Next on the agenda is staff reports. We'll start with any staff updates.
For the first time in ever, have a new staff person to introduce to you. Board, meet Jennifer Plessier. She is our museum director. And Jennifer, I prepped her. You want to step up to the mic and you won't hear it because it's really just in the camera, but give the board a little background and a little information about yourself, please.
Sure. As Jim said, my name is Jennifer Putzier, and I have just rounded out my first month as new director of the Depot Museum. Thank you for not making me come on my first day. Prior to taking the job here, I was at the Aurora Historical Society just downriver. I spent 15 years there curating their collections. So it's kind of nice seeing how much shared history we have, and I feel like that has given me sort of a really nice base to jump off of and learn more about Batavia's history. Besides working at the Historical Society, I also taught at Aurora University some of their classes in art history and museum studies. So got a well-rounded museum background. I really just wanted to say thank you to the Batavia Park District as well as the Historical Society for the warm welcome. I know that I have big shoes to fill with Carla Hill's retirement, but I have a ton of support. So, thank you.
Great, and this is where you can come over here and do the handshake.
Do the handshake.
The Walk of Fame.
Yeah.
I'll give you a high five.
Nice to meet you again. Nice.
Welcome.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome.
I have a cold. You want it?
I would like to add, though, that in the first month, we've already given her several challenges, and she has been able to meet them quite nicely and has come up with some information and already has a program in the summer brochure. So she's rocking it.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Great. Jennifer's a great addition to our team.
Awesome. Welcome forward to it. Welcome.
Thank you.
And don't feel obligated to stay.
I was going to say, it's a good experience for them.
It's up to them.
True. I wasn't in for a while.
All right, fair enough. Anyone else?
You can tune out for my part. That's, over the past month, the IT committee moved forward with a lot of initiatives. We moved forward with getting new computers for staff and larger monitors to help improve productivity. I think these are things that our staff greatly appreciates. Additionally, things maybe staff doesn't really, you know, appreciate as much. We got our ACA forms out, which seems like a requirement, but you have to relearn it every year. So it was quite an accomplishment for Christina and I to get that done and out the door. And then finally, this past month has just been a focus on our audit, getting everything in line for next month when the auditors are around my office, and it's been a great month.
Thank you.
Got a couple things. this week, if the weather holds out, as it seems like it's going to, we're going to be working on upgrading the lighting on the Peace on Earth statement on the pedestrian bridge, or the Peace Bridge as it is now called. Currently, we put a test section of lights up over the word Earth. and you can definitely tell the difference with the improved lighting and the...
What are you using, Eric?
They're LED light strips.
Okay.
And they have a higher lume rating than the ones that we were donated originally.
Great.
Have you seen it? It's much different.
It is.
I don't get out much at night.
Very clear.
I see it in the morning.
Coming across.
I have a picture if you'd like to see it. And the other thing I want to touch base on is that our superintendent of parks, Kim Hansen, was able to develop a report on our picnic shelter rentals for 2016. May and August were our peak rental times. But Big Woods was the highest rent here at 34 and Inkstrom at 27, even though we had construction going on.
So, and you think that's because there's more amenities in that park or just because of the size of the shelters? I'm just curious.
My personal opinion would be is the size of the shelter and the general location.
Yeah.
Okay. One's right to the high school, so, you know, Inkstrom, very popular and
right.
can be seen very easily. In Big Woods, you can't miss that hangar-sized pavilion.
Do you think it's because I live near there, are there, and a lot of Sundays in the summer, there's churches that have services there. Is that included in those numbers?
No.
No, okay. All right. Because that's very, always busy on Sundays.
That's it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We've had such a positive response from the zip line. People have their birthday parties up there now. And
awesome.
They love it.
So is there ice in the pond?
No,
yeah. No ice.
No ice. No ice. Okay, just checking. Red flags are shining. Excellent. So for our daddy-daughter date night, highest numbers thus far, 615.
Wow.
That's kind of big. We doubled up on the photo booth, and we actually managed to only run over maybe 10, 15 minutes. Everyone was able to get in and get out. Everyone had a blast.
600.
Yeah, well, we're shooting for more. It's Rotolo. We have the space. We can put more in there.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about the populace here in Batavia. It must be a lot of younger families moving in because it seems like...
It is a lot, yeah.
It was...
I got no kids left in my neighborhood.
They trickled in, so when I was up front, I didn't notice it until everyone was in, and then I walked in the cafeteria, and I was like, wow, there's a lot of people.
That's
here.
Awesome.
My neighborhood is transitioning.
Is it? Yeah.
All of the older kids have moved out, and now there's younger.
That's great.
It was a great experience. So hopefully next year we can touch more like 650, maybe 700. That would be awesome. Last thing I'm going to touch on, or the other thing I'm going to touch on, is this year we started a kindergarten basketball program just to see if we could actually make the kindergarten program run. And we have 39 kids, so it's fun. We're really trying to hit up the kindergarten type sports with the U6 soccer and the kindergarten basketball. So we're starting with the young ones and hook them and keep them in our programs till they're in high school.
I think you're onto a tagline there, hook them and keep them. Don't throw them back into the pond.
I'll rely on our marketing team to come up with a better tagline because I'm not good at that at all. And that's all I have, ladies and gentlemen.
Awesome. Thank you for the update.
Next, I'd like to introduce to the park board, now that Carrie Felkamp has left to go to the Elmhurst Park District after 9 years. She left for another opportunity. However, we were so fortunate to have the talent from within the park district that I was able to do a promotion from within with Mrs. Katie Drum. Katie Drum, and she's been with us for over 2 years. And she, in her first year at the Batavia Park District, she was actually a Bruce the Spruce Award recipient. The first time that the park district has ever given that award to a one-year-er. First-timer for a newbie. And last year when Carrie was out for 5 months, Katie did step in and stepped up to the plate, hit the ball out of the park. So it's with great pleasure I introduce to you our new Director of Marketing, Katie Drum.
Yay!
Congratulations.
Thank you. Katie. I just want to say thank you, Allison, and the board, as well as, don't freak me out, as well as the fellow leadership.
You can smack him anytime you want.
I intend to.
That's a bad direction.
We actually brought him in just for that.
Just for that purpose. I just want to say thank you. I'm so excited to step into this new role, and I just completely fall in love with Batavia for the past 2 years, and so I'm excited to kind of expand
my role here at the district. So.
Well, that's clear to us, awesome. And we're so happy that you were, want to stay with us and are promoted into that position. So congratulations.
Thank
to you.
You. Yeah. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Well, on to news from the marketing department. So the communications plan for the new RecTrack migration has been implemented. And I want to give a good shout out to Sharon Bringelson and Tiffany Green. They have done an excellent job for preparing marketing staff for this transition. And so we feel very confident that everything's going to go smoothly next week with that migration. And good news too, the brochure came early last Friday. So that gives our residents plenty of time to get in here to the Park District before this Friday, or excuse me, this Saturday to register. But we're looking to a smooth transition next week for that. And really great news. As you know, we had our Aloha Week last week, and it was a huge success. So we sold 1,154 passes during that week. And
that's more than 600.
Yeah, and that's last year we sold 780.
I was going to say, that's like more than double.
Yeah. But that's a 48% increase in passes, and it's a 67% increase in revenue. So awesome. Really
that's
successful.
So probably due to 70-degree weather.
Very excited about that that sale being a success.
Quarry's open in 2 weeks.
Aloha.
Quarry's open today, right?
That's right. And this Saturday is the second annual Bridal Showcase from 9 to noon at Shannon Hall. And we do have some new additions this year. We've added on an on-site photo booth. It's actually the same company that was at our recognition event. They're coming for free, which is wonderful, as a free service. And one of our sponsors will also be decorating Shannon Hall this year and the hallway. So that's adding a huge amount of value to this event. And the Park District will also be raffling off a free rental up to a $300 value. So we're hoping this will attract some additional attendees and definitely help our local brides out.
Terrific.
Yeah.
Sounds like fun.
Yeah.
Awesome. Anyone else? Board, any questions on staff reports?
No.
All right. So next item on the agenda is the Executive Director's Report, Strategic Master Plan Update.
Yes, actually the Strategic Master Plan Update was supposed to be in the January board agenda for distinguished accreditation, because that's when I gave the update, the actual update. Yes. So we have to have it in our agenda for distinguished accreditation. However, I do have I have my executive director report to give. We've got a little something, a little fancy, a little Star Wars like to present to you.
Do we have to move?
Nope. Okay. We have increased our technology.
Look at that.
Hocus pocus. Wow.
Who's controlling the remote? Oh, okay.
No one is.
And
our minds.
I would like to give kudos to Nick
Kochabar.
He is our facility trades crew leader, who was the mastermind behind the hanging of this, and Aaron Gold. He also is in charge of our technology committee, worked closely with Gary Motika and Nick on making sure that this happened. And then now cool. We can have nice, smooth transitions when
awesome.
We do our reports. We don't have to have a card table in the middle anymore.
Awesome.
So we're thrilled.
And I've said it before. I got to tell you, you know, I've been in corporate America for like 35 years, and these things are all over. I have never seen an installation that clean. Because when I came in, I read it on the, I read the report, and I said, okay, I want to see what this looks like. And Eric saw me. I was looking at every ceiling tile, and then I said, I double checked myself and said, well, maybe it was just a design study.
He did a nice job then, clean cutting the tegular edge right off of that.
It's angled, so it looks like it's still hanging. Gotta tell him, this is fantastic. My mind is blown.
Hey, anytime
we
can blow John's mind, especially with technology.
Yeah, I'm very impressed.
Awesome.
Very impressed.
Well, and you know, initially we were talking about a cage, but then you know, this is the room where we have a lot of the preschool gymnastics programs and sort of big balls being bounced up and down. And this by far wins the cage for
it. Awesome.
Yeah, it's very cool. Very cool.
You tell us to.
I just like to see it go up.
Raise that up. Raise the fire, right? All right.
I'm just hoping it doesn't fall.
No.
We can edit that out.
There's no way
that's coming down.
We can hang from that thing.
The rest of the ceiling's coming down. That thing's standing.
I'll just cue me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cue me.
Yeah.
Go.
All right, Katie Drum, our new director. Thank you for that.
Who's your ball guy?
Katie's personality, I just thought, you know, to start with this, our newest department head.
That's awesome.
She, again, she really immerses herself in every event she's a part of, and because of her, you know, the Park District's really grown, especially in sponsorships, and having had that role once before, this position is really kind of going back to very similarly to the position that I once had here, and she's done so much more sponsorships than I ever imagined. So I'm just incredibly proud to have her at this level. And I know Commissioner Tillman has said before that, you know, when we can promote people from within, it's a great day. It shows a lot about what we're trying to do in grooming people here and bringing them up to the next level. So here's the next level.
There's the next level.
All right, well, we talked a lot about the bridal showcase. We're extremely excited about this upcoming Saturday.
And this is how many of these have we had now?
The second.
This is the second.
Yeah.
Second, okay.
Our second, and it's a great opportunity to really showcase Shannon Hall now that it's finished. Last year, we hadn't even started the full process yet. So now it's in its heyday. We actually have our own booth there at the bridal showcase promoting Shannon Hall. But what's so nice is that all the vendors that are there can also talk about Shannon Hall and what they can do within that facility as well. Like videographers and photographers can point to specific locations and say, yeah, I can shoot you from over here, or I can stage this over here. So we're really pleased, and we're completely sold out on vendors. We have 30 total, so that's a plus. And we're just really excited to see, to track the marketing and see how many more people book with us as a result of this. All right, this isn't the New York Post, and this isn't the Riverwalk. This is actually at the Calvary Beach. So this is a fun little photo to share with you. I don't know what era that was. There wasn't a date on that photo.
The 30s?
Well, look at the car. That would tell you.
So those are 50s.
Yeah, it's 50s.
Early 50s. Chevy, you can't tell.
And the reason why I bring this up is because Bob Hansen, the owner of Funway, who's also the president of Main Street, has approached the Park District and said, you know, I love the look from the New York Post, the 1920s watercolor, and he wants to stage an event very similar to this one. And he approached Eric Lockard and said, what can we do to make it the ice thick enough to make it happen? Well, we're limited in what we can do in that capacity, other than Eric's in charge of the weather at every event that we have. But what Main Street's really going to be leading the charge for this, but they want to have a special event, and they want to have it between December 26th and January 7th. So they can't set the date because we have to have ice that's thick enough. And this wouldn't take place at the Halfway Beach, would actually be the Depot Pond. So Jennifer has been a part of that as well, a part of that discussion. It would be a staged event, so maybe a costume shop in town might be providing the 1920s, you know, scarves and mufflers. And they're asking that the Park District help out with programming, that the museums stay open hours, stay open a little later, and that we offer possibly help with the food booths and music and the Peg Bond Center rental. So right now it's very preliminary, but they're very excited about it. They are well aware that we have our Celebration of Lights event exactly 1 month prior, but they really want to have a picturesque look of Batavia, and maybe even have an artist create a brand new rendering at the Depot Pond. So the parking permit, I know we're switching gears quickly from 1950s to February 21st, 2017. But we are already knee-deep in selling the parking permit passes to high school students for South Angstrom Park. We only have 5 spots left out of the 22. And we require that everyone that has a permit has to have their driver's license first. So a lot of people are still waiting to get their driver's license before they can nab those 5 spots. We've had a lot of people say, can you just reserve a spot for us? Well, we have to make sure they have their license. So the police department's on board. They actually are going to be helping us, police, to make sure that the people that are supposed to be parking in the lot are. And if you recall, Dirk had said at one meeting to have a lot and not a slot. So we didn't spray paint numbers, they're just assigned a lot. And if we happen to have anybody that's handicapped, we do have those handicapped spots available. But right now, we haven't ended up giving any of those out. So for those of you at home, it's $85. And you can come in through the park district, and we'd be happy to serve you. So only five left. So bring in. As we mentioned, daddy-daughter date night, which was a huge success with 615 registrants. We partnered with Town and Country Gardens for flowers this year and sold 58 corsages with a little bit of a markup. So it was just a win-win situation all around. This is the first year that we've actually had a carnival component to daddy-daughter date night too. So I had a little bit of a theme to it. It wasn't just the dance, the DJ, the photo booths. So kudos to Brittany Bruno and Dean staff for really making it happen and making it extra special. Next. All right, so yes, we organized two booth balls. This is a photo from the Community Resource Expo. Last year we had called it the Volunteer Fair, but at our park district we have a volunteer committee, and the volunteer committee had decided to change the name to Community Resources, because there were a lot of affiliate organizations or resourceful organizations that weren't necessarily looking for volunteers, but they were looking to help people in the community. So the name changed from Volunteer Fair to Community Resource Expo. We completely sold out of vendor spots, and kudos to Katie and the marketing team. They went out and sought out every single spot to make sure that it was filled. So, this was the day after daddy-daughter date night, or the morning after. So you can imagine staff, daddy-daughter date night on Friday night, sold out event to the Community Resource Expo. So thank you to all staff that put in the extra hours.
Dean looks like a weatherman up there.
Paul Conrad?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
So this is for all the people that ask if we work full-time during the winter. Yes, we do. In fact, we're so busy. We have a lot going on with planning, and obviously we've got events that go on throughout the entire year. Next. This is a reminder that we are in the thick of seasonal hiring. So right now on our website, we have openings for park technicians, camp counselors, quarry cashiers, lifeguards. Everything is open on our website right now. So we are hoping that to attract as much talent as we can, and we are the largest employer of youth in town. So just please spread the word. We want to let people know that now is the time to apply, and then we conduct interviews during spring break. So if you know of anybody at home, please join this great group of people. Next. We did talk about this, but I thought I'd end up a little bit on a warm note. Aloha Week, with the 1,154 passes sold, which was a 48% increase from last year. And just to note that this was a flash sale. So we did a few teasers ahead of time, but then for one whole week, it was on Facebook, it was on Twitter, getting the word out, email blasts. But being a flash sale, you know, people, I need to get ready for it. And what's interesting is the number of people that actually from the year before were asking when it's going to be, which kind of defeats the purpose of a flash sale. But customer service wise, our front office, both Eastside and Civic Center, to their credit, did let people know, hey, it's coming up, pay attention the week of, just to give them the courtesy so they didn't miss it because they were on vacation.
Yeah, sure.
So we were really excited about that. One more. Oops, I ended on a cold note after all. But
that is true.
Yeah. So that's an upside.
The reminder that there's snow on Saturday, or the call for snow, right, Dean? Weatherman?
Yeah. Currently, they're not calling for snow. They're calling for cool conditions.
30s and rain, right?
At one point.
Rain.
A wintry mix.
But it's the weather. It can change in.
Use your hands.
All right, and that's
good job.
Well, thank you. Nice update. Nice work.
Make it good.
Please make it go up.
Make it go up. Watch it.
You want me to?
Yeah.
We got to bring it back down later, though.
Oh, really?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
We don't want to break it.
No, it's for executive session that we'll bring it back down. It's fine.
So fancy.
It is. And it just disappears. Yeah.
You guys want to see it come back then?
No. I like the fact that it's...
Wow.
All right.
Are you really keeping it down?
We can leave it there.
All right. Ooh, so next item on the agenda is old business, capital development plan progress report.
I have three items that I can update you on. Obviously, a little later in the meeting here, we're going to be awarding the contract to our ADA project at the lodge, renovating the 1950s washrooms. We are also going to be awarding the playground replacement for Prairie Path Park and Fiddler Farm Park. Both those bids were opened last week, and we're very happy with the results. I am going to be meeting with the, last month I told you I had contacted three engineering firms. I'm meeting Friday with the firm that we would like to engage. We will be discussing scope, final scope and fee, and then we will be hopefully engaging them for sure. That will be the design and construction documents this year for reconstructing the East Side Center parking lot. And then we're working on specs right now for replacing, again, reconstructing the, it's the section of the Fox River Trail which runs on the west side of the river from the bottom of the Union Street Hill south to where the old South Dam was. We own the section of the trail that far south. So it's basically right across from, right across the river from Funway, down that far. Mm-hmm. So we're going to be grinding that out and replacing that section of trail. So
definitely needs it. I was on it Sunday.
Yeah. Yes, it does. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's been it's been a challenge for Eric and his crew, and they've done real good keeping up with it. But it's time to have to replace it. So, I need to mention that we are going to be working again with Kids Around the World. They have said that they want to take both of our big playgrounds out.
Awesome.
So we will be scheduling that. We hope getting them in the schedule and then getting the contractor, if the weather holds, why hopefully mid-March, we would be able to start on the beginning part of that replacement process.
So and they actually do the removal, Jim?
They do the removal.
Okay.
Yeah. They take it at the ground level. They don't take the concrete footings.
Yeah, right.
They
right.
just slice them off and then they weld ends back on them, and it's right. an amazing process what they go through out there.
Let's make sure we get some photo and tweets going on.
Oh, I do. Yeah. That's great, yeah. Well, she'll have to tweet.
He's a twit.
You give her the photo, she can tweet.
He's a twit, but not a tweeter. No.
So, that's for now. We'll talk about the bids here in a minute.
In about 1 second?
Awesome. In about 1 second.
Okay.
Yes.
So then, item number 13A is the award of the bids for the restroom renovation at the lodge at Laurelwood. So I entertain a motion to approve
here.
I entertain a motion to approve the award of the contract for the restroom renovations at the lodge at Laurelwood for the lowest to the lowest responsive bidder, Lob Construction, in the amount of $53,143.
So moved.
Second.
So motion by Tillman, second by Foyles. Great turnout. Jeez Louise, on a small project.
That's
unbelievable.
It was crazy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it was steamy room only.
It was, yeah, it was.
Oh, really?
Wow.
Yeah, in the conference room it was.
What were they working on today? I walked the path and they were working on something down there.
What day was it?
Today. This morning.
Oh, in the conference room?
Oh, no. At the lodge.
Oh, at the lodge? I don't know what was going on at the lodge today.
It might have been our guys. Yeah. Never mind.
Okay. So I have a motion and a second on the floor. Any further discussion? Please call the roll.
That's you.
Oh, gosh. Who was the first and second? Tillman?
Oh, no.
Tillman and Foyles.
Oh, thanks.
Okay. Riley.
We got to go back to staff report.
Do you want to start?
No, I'm good. Tillman.
Aye.
Riley.
Aye.
Foils.
Aye.
Gray.
Aye.
Callahan.
Aye. Motion carries. So the next item on the agenda is 13B, award of the contract for the playground replacement projects at Prairie Path Park and Fiddler Farm. So I would entertain a motion to award the contract for the playground equipment replacement projects at Prairie Path Park and Fiddler Farm Park to the lowest responsive bidder, E. Hoffman, Inc., in the amount of $195,168.
So moved.
Motion by Tillman, second by Foils. I do have a quick question. Is it only two bidders?
Yeah.
Wow.
And we had 12 plan holders.
Oh, we did have 12
plan holders. Oh, yeah.
Wonder
yeah,
why.
I don't know.
It's a nice project.
It's a nice project.
Early,
and
it's early in the season, too.
It's, yeah. We tried to do it now in order to get a lot of those folks in.
But I think based on our previous bids that we've seen, I mean, this is right in par with where we targeted it to be anyway, so it's not
yeah.
Like,
oh, yeah.
So, all right.
Tillman.
Aye.
Foils.
Aye.
Riley.
Aye.
Gray.
Aye.
Callahan.
Aye. Motion carries. All right. Got some work to do.
Yep.
We'll get rolling.
Thank you.
You're welcome. It is kind of scary to have already done this once at each of these parks.
Oh,
still
yeah.
Sitting here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, both of them.
Feeling.
You know the feeling?
Yeah,
yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, Fiddler was the first one that we did within
yeah,
the current plan, within the our process, so 16 years.
Well, you know, honestly, I think it's a testament to the commitment of not only the folks who work for the Park District, but this community to want to have good parks and allow us to continue to do what we're doing financially to make sure this
absolutely
so we can mm-hmm. do it, so that's great. So, go ahead, have fun with that.
Cool.
Next on the agenda is 14, Fox Valley Special Rec Association.
Yes, they are getting ready for their barbecue dinner and mm-hmm. raffle. So I will be in probably in the next week or two sending out an email.
Hitting us up, you mean?
Hitting you up.
Okay.
Yep, it's a great fundraiser.
It's a great cause, absolutely.
Yep.
And they're doggone good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Do a great
pork
job.
Pork chops.
Yeah.
And apples.
I had to. You say it right, though.
You have to say it properly.
Pork chops.
Thank you.
Katie, what's we that? Have fun at our board meetings.
She's been here. Yeah.
Next on the agenda is 15, David Parks Foundation. Any update from the
I have nothing to report. Do you? No.
Okay.
No.
Thank you for that detailed
You're
report.
You're welcome. I worked hard at it.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
But then at some point, the logo rollout, because they are working on their new logo. Oh.
Yes. So maybe now with Katie. No longer with Carrie. Now with Katie.
So maybe at the next board meeting, we can bring a visual aid to show you what
That'd
their
be
new
great.
Logo is.
If they have it.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know when the next meeting is?
I'll talk to you after.
So how do you want to handle executive session?
I just heard the doors.
Oh, look at that. Timing, perfect.
Great.
Must have been watching on BATV. Oh, it's not live.
What? I'm going to shave for nothing.
Probably going to be fairly long.
This is Tuesday Night Live. You know.
Okay, so I would entertain a motion to enter into executive session to discuss land acquisition 2C5 and personnel 2C1 under the Illinois Open Meetings Act.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Tillman, second by Gray. Any further discussion? Please call the roll.
Tillman.
Aye.
Gray.
Aye.
Riley.
Aye.
Foils.
Aye.
Callahan.
Aye. Motion carries. We are going into executive session. Thank you very much. We have no business to come before us after executive session, so we appreciate you joining us this month, and we will see you in March.